Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a photo of someone into the look of a beautiful colored pencil and pastel drawing. I'll also show you how to quickly apply the effects to different photos. I provided this pencil lines file for you to download. Its link is located in my video's description or project files. Open a photo of a person you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one and the others from Shutterstock.com. The first step is to make a selection around the subject. There are many ways to do this, however, for this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, its brush size should depend on the size and resolution of your photo. Generally, I find 4 to 20 pixels works well. Drag your cursor over your subject to select it. If you want to remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Click the Refine Edge button or go to Select and Refine Edge. I did an in-depth tutorial on Refine Edge, so if you're not familiar with it, you should watch that tutorial. I provided its link as well. Drag the radius to the right and check Smart Radius. Drag your brush over the edge of your subject, especially the hair. Your quick mask doesn't have to be perfect, since we'll be blending and blurring the image later. I'll increase the smoothness a bit and output it to a new layer with layer mask. Then click OK. Before we place our subject into the pencil lines document, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. You know a layer is a smart object if this icon is at the lower right corner of its thumbnail. The reason we converted the subject into a smart object is that it allows us to modify or change the filters that we'll be adding whenever we want. It also allows us to change the subject without having to redo all the effects. Press V to open your Move tool and drag your subject onto the tab of the pencil lines document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and release. To adjust its size, open your transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If your subject is too large to see the transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the transform and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Rename it Soft Light and change its blend mode to Soft Light. Reduce its opacity to 50% and hide the layer. Rename the other layer Hard Light and change its blend mode to Hard Light. Go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and Iris Blur. This filter, along with the Field Blur and Tilt Shift, were first introduced in version CS6. The Iris Blur window will open in the Blur Gallery. Make sure Preview is checked in the Options bar. When we go inside the outer ring, we see a center pin which has a circular dial surrounding it. By rotating the dial, we can adjust the amount of blur within the outer ring. This automatically moves the blur slider in the Blur Tools panel. Conversely, by manually dragging the blur slider, it will automatically rotate the center dial. The four dots between the center ring and the outer ring control the transition area of the blur. The blur begins at these four dots and grows progressively stronger as we move outward. However, for a more subtle transition, move the dots closer to the center point. Surrounding the outer ring are four dots and one square icon. Dragging the square icon inward makes the outer ring appear to be more of a rectangle with rounded corners. By dragging any of the dots, you can adjust the overall shape and rotation of the blur by dragging the curved line. This adjusts its elliptical shape and rotation angle. We can move the blur to a different area of the image simply by clicking inside the ring and dragging it to a different spot. Lowering the focus amount will add blurring to the normally protected area, but for this example, I'll keep it at 100%. When you're happy with the blur, click OK. If you want to reposition your subject, shift-click on the top layer to highlight both layers. Then, just move it. The iris blur filter will move with your subject. To replace your photo, double-click on the top smart object to open it. Go to File and place Embedded. Find the replacement photo in your computer and click it. Then, press Place. Go to a corner and resize and reposition it. As before, make a selection around your subject to ultimately separate it from its background. Hide the original photo that's under your new photo by clicking off the eyeball icon next to it. Close the tab of this file, and when you see this warning, click Yes to save the changes. The smart object is now updated with your new image. All we have to do at this point is to resize and reposition it, and then adjust the iris blur. Shift-click the bottom photo to highlight both layers, and open your Transform tool. If you see this message, click OK. See your Transform's entire bounding box and resize and reposition your subject. Accept the Transform and fit it back onto your canvas. Double-click the Blur Gallery filter and adjust your iris blur for this particular photo. Then, click OK. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.